He said that there is a hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari. And the origin of his question is that usually when we're asked about a family member, the father, working in an interest-based bank, and he deals in riba, transactions, or he sells alcohol in his shop, and he brings a revenue and he feeds his wife and children. What's the ruling on that? The scholars say the reward and the benefit is for the people that he provides for, his dependents, and the sin and the burden is on the person earning. So the sin is on him. There's no sin on them because they're not collaborating with him, and it is his responsibility to feed them so that the money becomes halal. Why does the money become halal? Because this is the origin in Islam. The Prophet ﷺ was invited once by a Jew woman to eat lunch. So he went, accepted her invitation. The Prophet knows that the earning of the Jews is through usury and cheating people and dealing in interest. Yet he did not ask this woman, did you buy this sheep from haram money or from halal money? He simply ate, which means that it is sinful for her to earn. It is halal for us to eat and enjoy. And therefore, if a person, and this is related to the third question of his, if a person dies leaving a wealth which is mixed between haram money and halal money, like a person working in a bank or in an insurance company or sells intoxicants or sells cigarettes and tobacco and hookah or whatever they call it, or sells or deals in entertainment, movies, music, all of this is haram earning. So now he's dead and we have the inheritance. What should we do with the money? Distribute it. It is halal for you as heirs of the deceased. He will be punished for it in his grave and on the day of judgment, inshallah, azza wa jal, for his bad earning. So now, brother Labib says, okay, I understood this concept of yours. My issue is that there is a hadith in Sahih Imam Bukhari where his servant once brought him food and Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, was fasting. Usually he asks, where did you get the money from? Or where did you get the food from? This time he didn't. He ate one morsel. Then he remembered and he said, where did you get this food from? And the boy said, when I was a slave at pre-Islamic era, I pretended to be a soothsayer. So I predicted something in the future. I didn't know anything about it. I was just, you know, conning them. And they believed me. Now, after Islam and after so many years, they saw me and they gave me this food. So Abu Bakr kept on putting his finger and trying to throw out what he had eaten, and he managed to do that with difficulty. So he's asking me now, if the earning of the servant was halal, why did Abu Bakr throw it up? First of all, no one had ever done this except Abu Bakr. All scholars say no one had ever threw up what they consumed of haram after knowing from the companions except Abu Bakr. Secondly, the servant belongs to Abu Bakr. The clothes on the servant is Abu Bakr. A slave belongs to his master and everything he earns. And that is why a slave can never inherit someone who's free. So if a son is a slave and his father is free, and the father dies, the slave cannot inherit his father, because then the master would take everything because I own the slave and what he possesses. So I hope this answers your question.